Rev up your engines. Today I'm going to talk about the end of the Volkswagen Beetle again. Volkswagen recently announced that as of 2019, they're no longer going to be manufacturing the new Beetles. Now, to understand this fully, we'll go into the history of Volkswagens. The first Beetle, which is called the Type 1 because it was the first car that Volkswagen made, was made from 1938 to 2003. And they sold over 21.5 million of those things. Now, they started out tiny. They were 1,100 cc's and they put out 24 horsepower. And the last models that were sold in the American market, they bumped them up to 1,600 cc's. And they put out 53 horsepower. That was in 1978 in the United States. And because they were worried about the weak frontal crash ratings of the Volkswagen Beetle, because the engine was in the back and the gas tank was in the front, and that they really didn't work very good with air conditioners on them, in 1974, Volkswagen introduced into the United States the Golf, or the Rabbit, whatever you want to call it. In Germany they call it Golf, and in the United States they called it the Rabbit. And those were basically front-wheel drive, four-cylinder, water-cooled engines. And in 1979, that was it for Volkswagen Beetles, the old ones in the United States. They only sold the Rabbits in the United States then, in 1979. They went from an air-cooled, simple, rear-wheel drive car to a relatively complex, water-cooled inline four that was front-wheel drive. And then you jump closer to the present day, in 1998, Volkswagen introduced the new Beetle in the United States. It was basically the Volkswagen Rabbit or Golf with a beetle-shaped body planted on top of it. Other than its beetle-like shape, it had very little to do with the original Beetle. It was a high-tech German car. It wasn't a simple air-cooled car you could maintain yourself cheaply. They were very expensive to maintain. The Volkswagen dealers charged small fortunes to work on the cars. And on these new Beetles, when those automatic transmissions went out, hoo-wee, I've seen people spend anywhere from $4,000 to $6,000 having them repaired. And yes, this is the United States that I'm talking about. Almost everybody buys automatic transmissions. So most of those Beetles, they were sold in automatic transmissions, not manuals. And the new Beetles, hey, they were often marketed as a woman's car. They came with a little vase inside with a plastic flower. You know, maybe they're also owing to flower power, but really, they're no more as a woman's car. And the convertibles with the top came down, people called them baby buggies, because that's kind of what they look like. And really, the new Beetles were rather a failure in terms of sales. Hey, they only sold 500,000 of them from the year 1998 to 2019. Compare that to the 21.5 million old Beetles that were sold, and you'll see it was a massive flop compared to the old Beetle. Now, granted, the old Beetle would have never made it in modern society. Biggest engine they made put out 53 horsepower in 1978. And hey, 2018 one puts out 181 stock horsepower. Our version has 210 horsepower. And they even have a Polo rally car Beetle that puts out 375 horsepower. But really, when you consider the shape of it, it's relatively un-aerodynamic. And if you put 375 horsepower in that Beetle shape, hey, you're much better off with a sleeker, lower to the ground design that's more aerodynamic. If you want something fast to race around in, you know, these things are never going to be able to compete to any real race car designed modern engine. So really, why did the new Beetle fail? Well, because it wasn't any kind of radical change like the original Beetle that was a car for the people. Cheap to buy, cheap to maintain, and anybody could buy one and drive it all over the place. They were really dependable. Where the new Beetle, heck, it was just a Volkswagen Rabbit or Golf with a different body slammed on the top of it. It wasn't anything new. They were just going for a particular shape. Another motoring analogy to that, you could say, is the PT Cruiser. Now, when they first came out, the PT Cruisers, they had a cool shape, like retro gangster shape stuff. But hey, the things were horrible pieces of junk and fell apart, you know? Now, the Volkswagens, granted, were built a lot better than they were. But still, they weren't any kind of a radical change. And they weren't something that people were just dying to buy. In this respect, the new Beetle was kind of like that AMC Pacer, that crazy looking wide car with the windows all around that made it look like you were driving around in a fishbowl. It was originally a huge success. AMC tried to make as many of them as they possibly can. They had kind of a small manufacturing facility in Indiana. But after the first couple of years, everybody that wanted a weird looking car like that, hey, seemed to have bought it, and then they couldn't give the things away. Because really, cute only goes so far in the modern motoring world. Look at the Fiat 500. It was a massive flop in the United States. They originally, when they started out, one year they sold about 50,000 of the things. Now they're only selling a couple thousand of them, and they'll probably end up pulling them out of the United States because, hey, it's just lack of sales. How many people want a little car like that that really doesn't ride all that well when there's all kinds of better choices out there? And with a relatively horrible track record of a Volkswagen Beetle, I never had a single customer ever buy a Volkswagen new Beetle and buy another one. They had so many problems as they got older, and it cost so much money to maintain that they just gave up and never bought another Volkswagen product. So ultimately, Volkswagen decided they're not going to make the new Beetles anymore because, alas, the Volkswagen Beetle is a shape of the past, not the present or the future. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell!